Clindamycin is a lincosamide antibiotic used to treat serious infections caused by susceptible anaerobic, streptococcal, staphylococcal, and pneumococcal bacteria. In this video, let's find found. What is clindamycin? What is clindamycin used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking clindamycin? How does clindamycin work? How to use clindamycin? What is clindamycin? Clindamycin is an antibiotic medication used for the treatment of a number of bacterial infections, including osteomyelitis or joint infections, pelvic inflammatory disease, strep throat, pneumonia, acute otitis media, and endocarditis. It is available by mouth, by injection into a vein, and as a cream or a gel to be applied to the skin or in the vagina. Clindamycin was first made in 1966 from lincosamide. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. It is available as a generic medication. In 2020, it was the 125th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 5 million prescriptions. What is clindamycin used for? In oral and parenteral formulations, clindamycin is indicated for the treatment of serious infections caused by susceptible anaerobic bacteria, as well as susceptible staphylococci, streptococci, and pneumococci. Used topically, it is indicated for the treatment of acne vulgaris and is available in combination with benzoyl peroxide or tretinoin for this purpose. Clindamycin is also indicated as a vaginal cream, suppository, or gel for the treatment of bacterial vaginosis in non-pregnant females. Clindamycin is used for antimicrobial prophylaxis against viridans group streptococcal infections in susceptible patients undergoing oral, dental, or upper respiratory surgery, and may be used for prophylaxis against bacterial endocarditis in penicillin-allergic patients at high risk of these infections. Contraindication. Clindamycin is contraindicated in patients who have had an allergic reaction to it, and it should be used with caution in those who have a history of regional enteritis, ulcerative colitis, or antibiotic-associated colitis. Side effects. Common adverse drug reactions associated with systemic clindamycin therapy, found in over 1% of people, include diarrhea, pseudomembranous colitis, nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain or cramps, and/or rash. High doses, both intravenous and oral, may cause a metallic taste. Common adverse drug reactions associated with topical formulations, found in over 10% of people, include dryness, burning, itching, scaliness, or peeling of skin, lotion, solution, erythema, foam, lotion, solution, oiliness, gel, lotion. Additional side effects include contact dermatitis. Pharmacodynamic. Clindamycin is active against a number of gram-positive aerobic bacteria, as well as both gram-positive and gram-negative anaerobes. Resistance to clindamycin may develop, and is generally the result of base modification within the 23S ribosomal RNA. Cross-resistance between clindamycin and lincosamide is complete, and may also occur between clindamycin and macrolide antibiotics, e.g. erythromycin, due to similarities in their binding sites. As antimicrobial susceptibility patterns are geographically distinct, local antibiograms should be consulted to ensure adequate coverage of relevant pathogens prior to use. Mechanism of action. Clindamycin inhibits bacterial protein synthesis by binding to 23S RNA of the 50S subunit of the bacterial ribosome. It impedes both the assembly of the ribosome and the translation process. The molecular mechanism through which this occurs is thought to be due to clindamycin's three-dimensional structure, which closely resembles the three ends of L-promet tRNA and deacylated tRNA during the peptide elongation cycle, in acting as a structural analog of these tRNA molecules. Clindamycin impairs peptide chain initiation and may stimulate dissociation of peptidyl tRNA from bacterial ribosomes. The mechanism through which topical clindamycin treats acne vulgaris is unclear, but may be related to its activity against Propionibacterium acnes, a bacteria that has been associated with acne. Half-life. The elimination half-life of clindamycin is about 3 hours in adults and 2.5 hours in children. Half-life is increased to approximately 4 hours in the elderly. Dose. The dose of this medicine will be different for different patients. Infections. Aerobic gram-positive cocci and the more susceptible anaerobes, not generally including Bacteroides fragilis, Peptococcus species, and Clostridium species other than Clostridium perfringens. 600 to 1200 mg/day 4/IM/QID. More severe infections, particularly those due to proven or suspected Bacteroides fragilis, Peptococcus species, or Clostridium species other than Clostridium perfringens, 1200 to 2700 mg/day 4/IM/QID. For more serious infections, these doses may have to be increased. In life-threatening situations due to either aerobes or anaerobes, these doses may be increased. Doses of as much as 4,800 mg q-day given 4 to adults. Single intramuscular injections of greater than 600 mg not recommended. Safety advice. Pregnancy category B. In clinical trials with pregnant women, the systemic administration of clindamycin during the second and third trimesters has not been associated with an increased frequency of congenital abnormalities. Clindamycin should be used during the first trimester of pregnancy only if clearly needed. That's all the information about clindamycin we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.